This is the second part of the dress that we're making, and for any member that loves the design element of sewing, then this is for you, because this is where you can actually go mad and do your creations and do your different designs. Now, the design that I'm going to make is going to be like a frilled out dress on this fabric, and I'm going to use the length of this find another tape measure, which I don't know what I've gone and done with. Okay. I haven't got a design at hand what I'm going to do with this. It's one of those old design dresses that I'm making, which I made a very, very long time ago. Now, the length of this I'm going to keep as 40 inches. I will mark it out for the neckline. From the top is going to be basic to any other dress that we make. It is the bottom half of the dress which is going to be slightly different. So from the shoulders, I'm going to keep this 15 inches, just as I would with any other of my camisa. The armhole, I'm going to curve it out as with any other camise, and then I will shape it. I will actually shape this up to the waist area, and here I'm going to take out like a panel, and over here I'm going to add a rounded panel, which is going to be the difference in this camise. So it's going to be like the camisa of today, but at the same time it's going to have a slightly different twist to it. And this is where we're going to add that little bit of the twist. So here I'm going to, what I've done is I've curved this part of the camise out, and it's from the area of, I'm just going to show you on my dress what I'm going to do. It's going to be, my clothes are absolutely filthy, I've got so many marks on them, but it's a lazy Sunday, and I'm actually at the moment I'm just concentrating on finishing this tutorial before I get changed. Now this dress, it will fall to here, and then here I've curved it out, and it's around here that I'm going to add a different piece of fabric that's going to sort of have like a rounded off dropped sides coming around this area. You will have to see the result in order to understand it, because what you will have is you will see the result of this, and then you can go back to the cutting and understand this a lot better. In a way, it's sort of going backwards to what I'm doing, but I will come back and I will explain what I am doing in this particular video at a later stage. And so the camise I'm going to cut out, what you basically have is a camise which has been cut like this, which is from here, it's like a normal camise, and then I'm going to insert the panels that are going to actually drop from that area. I'm going to dart it in the center and obviously do the neckline and so on. So the end result is going to be different to what you're looking at now, obviously. But these are just my two front pieces. I am going to cut out my panels, which I will insert on the sides. This was a 2 meter of fabric that I took. Generally, if I was doing this as This is just, it's very, very long time ago when I made these dresses. So I'm actually replicating something that I did maybe 20 years ago in my early sewing days. So this is the fabric that I've just basically turned over, and I will add to this is the fabric that I'm going to add like this going around. Sort of like this, curved around, and then that is the hemline, and that will be like the dropped sides. So half of this will go on the one side, half of this will go on the other side, and then the other sides, it will not have a joint, it will not have jars, and it will have the effect of the dropped cornered type of a camise. And so I'm just figuring out whereabouts to actually cut this from. Now this design, you cannot work with this design on all types of fabrics. So because your other side of your dress, you have to look at your fabric that you are using for this design. Preferably either use a fabric which is plain, or a fabric which is got small pattern, that the pattern is not going in one direction. Because if you used a pattern which was an all over pattern, then your result would not, if you had a bold pattern, the result would not come out. So that is my pieces that I will be inserting. I mean, this is a readaptation of an original design that I did very long time ago. And the readaptation is that when we first initially did these designs, we actually rounded these off absolutely evenly so that the drop would go all the way around evenly. Obviously the change in the fashion is a little bit different now, and we are actually looking at a slightly different variation where the look is, you know, more towards the dropping sides. Now, if you were making this and if you wanted the drop of the sides to be less, then you would curve that off to make it more rounded. I am going to, at the moment, I am going to work on this as it is. I won't actually do anything else. The only thing that I will do is I'm going to insert maybe a small piping going around here to emphasize where my curved lines are placed, or maybe even not, you know, just depending on, I don't know, I think maybe on this one I will leave it as it is. But I will use the hem, my fabric that I had left over from my other dress, I may use that as my hem piece at the bottom.